So hi Akansha, how are you?
I'm good, sir. How are you, sir?
Yeah, I'm good too. Thank you. So can you tell us something about yourself?
So my name is Akansha Gupta. I'm from Bihar. I have completed my BTech from GL Bajaj Institute of Technology and Management in 2015. I have done my schooling from my hometown, and I have 2.3 years of experience in RDS Webtech LLP in Noida location. That's all about myself.
Okay. So let's say if you are given some user story for testing or for executing the test cases, so what do you do at that time?
Sir, in user story is in a sprint, and there is some sprint duration, like 2 weeks. Then we taken like from there, and write that first we review it and writing the test cases, and as per the test cases we execute it, and then if we found any bug, then we log the bug in Jira tool.
Okay. So let's say if you are given a test cases to be reviewed for one of the person who is junior than you. So what are parameters you will take into the consideration while reviewing the test cases?
Sir, first we check from the SRS that what is the requirement is what is the client requirement, and as per this we write the test cases, and
Then apart from that, what all things you will check in the test cases?
we check that how many test cases have passed and how many test cases have failed.
Okay. See, now you might get this type of question, in an interview, like how will you review the test cases? So over there, you have to make sure that you convey to them that you are checking whether all the positive test cases, the happy path, covering the happy flow, positive flow of the
Yes, sir.
application is covered. Then negative test cases should also be covered. Then
Yes, sir.
the proper testing design techniques, like if it's an input field, if it's a text box field, then have they used boundary value analysis or equivalence partitioning?
Equivalence,
Those
yes.
kind of techniques have been used. What is the test data that has been used by the team members? Let's say if it's a functionality to upload a file. So are they testing with everything like 10 MB, 100 MB, 1 GB, what is the file limit?
Size, yes, sir.
Test data. So test data plays a very important role in finding defects. So these all things you have to take care when you have to review someone's test cases. So this might be asked in an interview. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So see, this is a mock interview. Even if you don't know the answer of the question, so you will be told the answer of the question, and you will be explained as well, so that if this kind of question comes to you in a real-time interview, you should be able to tackle it. Okay. So even if you get confused, you're not able to understand completely, please feel free to stop me and ask again. We'll explain it. Okay. Now, what
Okay,
is
sir. Sure.
sprint? Yeah, what is sprint planning?
Sprint planning. And sprint planning from the senior level, from in sprint planning, how many you, yeah, like the whole number of requirement is divided into the user story. It is, and then user story is in the sprint. A number of, and Scrum planning from the Scrum Master.
No, not scrum planning, sprint planning.
Sprint planning.
Yeah, sprint planning.
Sprint planning, once first sprint are divided, and once the first sprint is over, then we go to the another sprint, and the requirement are like divided into the small chunks.
Right. So, in the sprint planning, the entire Scrum team will be coming together at the beginning of the very sprint it is done. And they will be doing the
Yes,
planning,
sir.
like which all user stories they are going to target, how many defects they are going to target. So those all
Yes, sir.
things
There is
will
some
be.
meeting, sir. Yes, retrospectrum, and they talking about the further sprint and previous sprint and the upcoming sprint. They are talking about it.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Now coming to next question, what is daily Scrum?
daily scrum.
You are following agile methodology, right? In your company, in your organization.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what is daily scrum?
Daily scrum is it's called as per the meeting, it's we're taking that to what we do for what is the task for yesterday, what we have do for today, and any issues which you have facing, then we can mention.
Right. So daily scrum meeting, or you can say stand-ups, this meeting is carried out every day for 15 minutes. The whole team will be sharing about their previous day achievements, task completions. If they have any impediments, those would be raised. If they have any blockers, so let's say if QA team is having any blocker in testing the user story, so they'll be focusing, they will be highlighting those kind of issues, right? So bringing the problems or issues on the surface, that is the main motive behind this daily scrum. Okay, now what is the role of tester in sprint planning?
Tester in sprint planning.
What actually a tester will do in sprint planning?
In sprint planning, we check that what is the task. First, we take from the sprint, what is the task. Then first step is to write the test cases. We are using Excel sheet and write the test cases and execute it. And like all the positive, all the valid data from and invalid data, and we check that the functionality and that is working correctly or not. Or we, if we putting the invalid data, then we got the message like message comes or not, like not able to log in like this. We write all those things in RTM, requirement testability matrix, and like this we can check.
Okay, so these are all the things that you will be performing the kind of testing, right? But actually, sprint planning, it's a kind of a meeting where you will be discussing and you will be trying to understand the user stories, and you will be asking the open-end questions to the product owner, to the development team, right? Then one aspect is also that you will be verifying whether the acceptance criteria that is mentioned in the user stories, those are testable, non-testable, whether all the functional criteria has been mentioned or not, whether all non-functional criteria are being mentioned or not. Okay. So estimation also takes one of the aspects. So this is the role of a tester whenever sprint planning is going on. So apart from doing activities, more of it's a planning activities, and it's an open-end forum where you can ask questions to POs, BAs, and development team. Okay. Now, on a similar line, you might get a question on what is the role of tester in the retrospective meeting. Okay. So what do you think? What is the role of a tester in retrospective meeting?
On retrospective meeting, we check that about that before 24 hours, what we have done, like what we have done before and like yesterday, we can mention and in the meeting. And what is the plan for today? And we can say if any issues, then we about the resources and anything like environment, then we can discuss in this meeting.
Okay. Now,
we are facing.
Yes. Please go ahead.
Yeah. If we are facing any issues, then we can discuss in this meeting.
Right. So, retrospective is done once the entire it is not done every day, like you were telling about yesterday and today. What you can add in the answer is you can tell like if the tester would have faced any issue or impediment during testing of the story in the previous sprint, or they can highlight the bottlenecks or all their impediments faced in the sprint, and they can suggest the improvements to overcome these for the future sprints. So it's not an activity that is just pertaining to the last 24 hours. It is an kind of
it's stand up call, sir. Actually, I got confused.
Yeah, no problem.
It's like we are discussing about the for our sprint once sprint is going
right. No issues at all.
And the about the further sprint.
Just understand, you know, sprint, scrum, then iteration, user stories, these are all the things that they will ask you, because you have mentioned in your CV agile methodology. So you will get all such kind of questions. Don't get confused at all.
Yes, sir.
These things are pretty simple, and you should, you know, be very confident when you're giving answers of these questions, because these are day-to-day activities. In and out, you will be doing this every day, right? So don't worry at all. Be calm, be cool, nothing, no problem at all. Okay, now, what are the functional test scenarios for testing database? Right. Let's say if you have to perform database testing, your manager or your leads call you and they give you some particular user story in which database testing has to be done. So can you tell me the functional and the non-functional scenarios, what all you will test with respect to database testing?
Sir, I didn't do the database testing.
Okay, okay, no issues. So let me give you the answer. Let's say if you get such question in an interview, so what you can do is you can tell them that for the functional scenarios, you will basically testing the functions that are there inside stored procedures, possible permutations and combinations that you will test, and whether end-to-end data flow is happening from backend to frontend. Let's say, from frontend to backend. Let's say if you are entering some values in the fields, are those values as it is going into the database or those are getting corrupted, right? So those are functional test scenarios. For non-functional test scenarios, what you will do is it's a kind of negative testing or performance testing. So you will be opening the database, you will be manually changing the values over there and see what happens in the front end thing. Okay. So inserting invalid values in the back end into the database and see what is the effect of those values on the front end. Okay. So that you can see. Okay. Now coming to the next question. You were mentioning about Jira. You are uploading defects, you are logging defects in Jira, right?
Yes, sir.
And which is the test management tool that you are using?
Test management tool.
Right, right. Test management tool, writing test cases.
Test cases, we are writing the test cases in Excel sheet.
Okay, in Excel file. So can you tell me the name of the columns or which are all the various fields that you are using or writing while writing test cases?
Okay, test cases. First date, test case ID.
Okay.
And then the test description. Description and then expected result. Steps, then expected result. And actual result. And then status.
Status.
Precondition and post condition is also there.
Right, right. Prerequisites are there. Post conditions are there. And what about test data? You're not incorporating that column in the test cases?
Test data, yes, sir.
Right. Test data is also coming. Right. So, yeah, right. I think you covered all the test cases columns. Okay, yes. Wonderful answer. Now, can you tell us some of the positive and negative scenarios to test the ad friend feature in the Facebook? So you might be using social media, right? Like Facebook is there, Instagram is there. So over there, ad friend feature is there, functionality is there. So can you tell me positive and negative scenarios to test that feature?
In Facebook?
Yes.
Ad friend, okay. First we search the person whom I want to send the request. And to verify that the Facebook gives the correct person information. Like if I'm searching you, then it's your name. And to verify that, we are able to click the add friend option. And to verify that you can get the friend request from my side. And again, to verify that the person whom I send the request, who is able to accept the request. And if I am an unauthorized person or unknown person, then there is an option to ignore from your side. And if you accept my friend request, then then it's successfully added in my friend list.
Mm-hmm.
And to verify, to communicate with the messenger. Messenger, we can communicate. And to verify that we can able to use the all the features like video call, audio call, or send the images, videos, there's an option. And these can we can verify.
Right. Wonderful. So these were all the positive test scenarios. Now, what about negative test scenarios?
Negative test scenarios. Once I search that person, and I send the request to you, but my request is going to another person automatically, or some issues, system issues or anything. And second one is you're not getting my request. Mm-hmm. If I'm sending you request successfully, but you are not getting my request.
Okay. One negative test scenario over here you can add is, let's say if you have blocked someone, then you should not be allowed to add them as a friend. Right?
Yes.
Or you have unfollowed someone or snoozed someone for some time. Okay. Unfollow or unfriend someone. So that kind of comes in the positive. But if you have blocked or you have reported some issue against someone, okay, some kind of comment or something, then you should not be allowed to add them as a friend. Okay, so that is part of a negative testing. Okay. Now, consider you are given a bank account login page. Okay. And there are fields, user ID, password, account number, and submit button. So four fields are there. I would say four things are there. User ID is a text box, password is a text box, account number is a text box, and there is a button, submit button. So which are all the test scenarios that you will perform to the testing?
For the testing?
Yes.
Okay.
You want me to repeat the question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you are given one bank account login page. Okay. And you have got three fields over there and one submit button. One field is account number. Then you have got a user ID field, password field, and at the last submit button. So can you tell me the scenarios to test it?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
To verify that first I'm seeing the positive test cases, the scenario, put the valid account number and user ID and password and click the submit button. It should be successfully login. And the second one is to put the incorrect account number. Like if 13 digit, then we put only 12 digit and the user ID and password and submit button. And then we can nothing put that is empty in the box. Then we can submit. Then the error message comes that not successfully or user ID password incorrect. And once we put all the data valid and go to the and click on the back button and check that the session is still active or not. We can check and we can put the valid all the valid data and try to submit like 10 times at a time to validate that is hanging or successfully login. And we can also put password incorrect, user ID incorrect to verify, and to verify that the all the alignment are correctly or not. Alignment we can verify. And to check that if we are testing some banking data, then we can also check the URL. Maybe it's unauthorization. So we can validate the URL, like HTTPS, like this, that is valid or not.
Right, that is a good test case. Authorization, then authentication as well, right?
Authentication, yes.
Mm-hmm. What else comes to your mind? Which are all the other test scenarios?
authentic, if I'm not authorized person, mm-hmm. but we, if we can, if authorization you are asking.
Mm-hmm. Right. So all kinds of scenarios we can cover.
Yes.
Authentication, authorization, then functional, non-functional.
Yes, sir. If I'm successfully logging to my account, then we check that to what we have, what access in authorization mm-hmm. we can check, which functionality I can use in authorization, and this type we can test, sir.
Right. Okay. You covered most of the test scenarios. It was good. Okay. Now, what else you can add in this is you can add about concurrent test scenarios. Let's say you are having one user profile. At the same time, sir. One of your team member also tries to log in with the same user profile. So both the logins should happen. And at the same time, considering this kind of concurrent testing, you can do with 30 users, 60 users, 100 users, 500,000 users based on the limit of the users.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is one aspect. Then another aspect is you can capture the username and the password, and you can try to manipulate it using man-in-the-middle attack. Like you can use any of the tool for security testing. Bubsuit is there, Fiddler is there, and you just have to change the request parameters and see what is the response coming up over there. Okay. Then authorization you covered, authentication, valid username, invalid password, invalid username, valid password, both are invalid, and
empty.
Right, empty, null values, white space characters, those things you can
use. Or password is like showing storage like this.
Right, it should be encrypted.
Not showing.
Right, yeah, then let's say if you are logging into the application and then you are hitting back button, then you are trying to click on redo button. So you should not be logged in again. It should show some message, session expiry or something. User friendly traffic to come at that time. So that is also one of the test scenario. Okay. So this was good. Okay. Now apart from BVA and EP, apart from boundary value analysis and equivalence partitioning, which are all the other testing techniques you are using to write test cases?
Yes, sir. In a boundary value analysis, like if any text boxes, mm-hmm. then we for example, account number, like is. Can I give you the example?
Yeah, sure. You can add examples to, make your answer more valuable.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. So we can take the input to like 16 to 35 age mm-hmm. is valid. So we can 16 minus 1, 16, 16 plus 1, mm-hmm. and the max value 35 minus 1, 35 and 35 plus 1.
Right.
And so these we can check like.
Right. So these are the test data for EP and boundary value analysis, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Apart from these testing techniques, which other testing techniques you are writing, you are using to write test cases? Have you used state transition? Have you used cyclomatic complexity?
No, sir. We are using boundary value analysis and equivalence partitioning, okay. and like this.
Okay, great.
No issues. I'm guessing.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, how does your day spend, right, from when you go into the office, when you start your work? So can you tell us the different activities that you take part into while doing testing?
Sir, currently we are working from work from home.
Mm-hmm.
And it's 10 to 6 is our shift timing.
Mm-hmm.
And before shift timing, there is meeting conduct. That is a stand-up call meeting about the what we have to do for today. Today work we have to assign. And we can check the first, we can log in the Jira tool and we can check our task in Jira tool. We can check the sprint, what sprint we have. And as per the sprint, we check the requirement and writing the test cases like this. And like as per the daily basis, we can write 25 to 30 test cases.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, sprint duration also, then we have to finish the work during this sprint. So we follow this type.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
Okay, Akansha, I'm done with the interview. Do you have any questions for me?
No, sir.